Ye Wubin's 100 Lessons to Mastering Time Management, Lesson 51, How to Deconstruct and Organize Complex Tasks. Hello everyone, my name is Ye Wubin from Neng. I am so happy to be with you now at 6 a.m. on the Ximalaya App. For those of you who have been following my lessons, welcome back. And if you're new here, welcome aboard. I am so happy to have you with us. Time is man's scarcest resource. Once it's used, it can never be regained. So if you're not using your time effectively, or if the time you are spending is only getting you further away from your dreams in life, then stay with me. Listen a while, and I am confident I can help open your eyes to a new path that will get you closer to your dreams. I want to remind you that there are 100 classes in this album, and every class lasts about 6 minutes. It is updated at 6 a.m. New York City time each morning. In the previous lecture, we talked about reflection. However, since we are talking about planning, a better word to use is clarification. We're taking an ambiguous task that has no form or intention and converting it into a clear, purposeful, and specific action. We talked about 3 questions. 1. Should I do this task? 2. What is the result I want? 3. What is my next step? Translate chores into action with these 3 questions. The key to productivity is not about how many things you complete, but to complete important things to the best of your ability. We can generate many great ideas throughout the day and night, but we can't always store and remember them well. Therefore, in order to capture these ideas for later use, we need to learn one technique: to collect these ideas using an effective system. Only after learning how to transfer these ideas safely out of your mind can we truly live in the present moment. You know, we only devote 1% of our energy on the randomly generated ideas and immediate tasks that crop up throughout the day. If we learn to write them down, it will free our mind of the energy needed to store this information and allow us to focus completely and fully on the task at hand. Open your notepad, software program, or whatever you're storing your tasks, and then ask 3 questions for each of them. Should I do this task? What is the result I want? What is my next step? These 3 questions will translate the chores into an actionable next step. Then, any task with a specific deadline should be scheduled on the calendar. Now here's the part I want to be very clear about. Remember this. First, make sure you determine the purpose of each task, and then second, focus on the method. Meaning, then method. Remember that not all of your tasks belong in your calendar or situation list. In other words, you should delete unimportant tasks. Tasks that we need to further contemplate or consider should be transferred to a pending list, perhaps one that is named possible or future tasks. Tasks which we have promised to complete very soon to other people should be put in their own list. For example, I talked about the task of getting a physical exam from a doctor. At first, this task was in the list of chores. We converted this task into an action with a specific result. I want a medical report. Therefore, the specific next step is calling to make an appointment for the physical exam. However, calling to make an appointment is only the first step. The second step, traveling to the medical exam, then waiting for medical report, reviewing medical report, and then setting up follow-up actions to satisfy the recommendations proposed by the medical report, are all follow-up items. This is called a process. A process is a series of steps, one after another, with a series of results coming out of each step, all propelling us towards a final finished result. When all of these steps are completed, the task is complete. The idea is to break down the arbitrary whole into concrete and meaningful individual steps. That is what it means to choose meaning before method. So far, we have converted the idea or task of a physical exam into a series of actionable specific steps. Of course, the physical exam is just an example. There are many examples all throughout your daily life that require you to break down the task into a series of steps. For example, giving birth to two children, traveling around the world, finding a good school for your children, writing a book, publishing a book. These are all examples of complex tasks that can be broken into simpler and more specific actions. We need to convert these tasks into meaningful intermediate steps. Also, when faced with these complex tasks, we ensure clarity by asking those three questions. We repeatedly ask the third question, what is my next step? So that we continue to break down the process into smaller and smaller items, moving the whole process toward the goal. So what is this item I'm talking about? These smaller and smaller items. An item is a series of steps that include all the actions needed to get the outcome we desire. Therefore, reflection and definite purpose are valuable, as it forces us to decide what exactly we're trying to accomplish, and then breaking down the process into its component parts, helping us obtain the results we want. For each item, we should determine whether it should be deleted, thrown into the trash, or included in a situation list, calendar, item list, or future maybe list. But remember, none of this can take place until we have a clear and definite list of chores in an inbox that we've collected over time. Now, as I've said before, time management is actually about the classification of tasks into meaningful systems. A few lessons ago, we talked about the 50,000 meter sky high life, which is the popular life navigation system. We talked about, number one, the runway, then 10,000 meters, that's the item, 20,000 meters, which are the 8 concerns of Sudoku, 30,000 meters, the goal, 40,000 meters, the vision, 50,000 meters, the aim or purpose. So from 20 to 50,000 meters, we reflect and view these concepts. The runway is the action list and the situation list. As we have just mentioned, the item is a collection of action lists of the same type and category which we focus on. That is at the 10,000 meter level. So remember, the item list is generated by the three questions. These audio lessons are translated by Yushaneng's partner Cici and then recorded by her husband Justin. I wish you great success today. See you tomorrow.